this level, that should never work.
I wanted to sing on my childhood song, but it's not well known anyway, so I don't know. Maybe I try it another time. There's a song I used to sing with my my mother. She used to sing with me. Like I'm singing, and then she sing the harmony with me. But let's not do that right now. Today, I know it's a very grim and serious time. You know, you've heard me talk and open up your Bible about the two things I said was coming upon this earth that the Lord showed me, the plague, whatever name they want to call it, virus, it's a plague, and the war. I've spoken about this thing, I've written about it, I've been teaching about it, and the time is very urgent. I've been talking about these things that I told you, the Holy Ghost said to me. He said to me last year, as the year was coming to a close, he said, draw it down very hard. Draw it down very hard. You know, the Lord showed me a vision in heaven, and it was about 2 years ago, I think, 4 years ago. And he brought me to heaven, and he showed me the coronation of King of Kings, the Lord Jesus, which is the same thing, and I couldn't, which then took me to Daniel chapter 7, after I woke, because I trembled, I shook, like, when I woke out of my bed, I was shaking, he took me there, that, and he explained to me, that's what you are seeing, that's what you are seeing in the vision. So, so many things have happened, some things I talk about, some people, they act like they, you know, they don't believe or whatever. It doesn't matter to me. I believe God. I've proven God in ways that, you know, hardly anybody on earth even knows. You understand? And when it comes to faith, I've seen things God do that, dazzle your brain, like. See, that's the reason why on Facebook, when I'm writing these things, the atheists and the Satanists, they get so mad because some of them, they can't even, people can't even believe some of these things. They are mad, the devil is mad, because so many times the devil start to destroy me, and I create a lot of problems for my life, you know, but I trust God. This morning I was getting dressed for, come on a program, and I remembered something that, you know, the Lord showed me, you know. We went away from home, and we were away for more than a week. And when we came back, and we pulled in the garage, you know, something said to me that I should go and check the house before the rest of the family goes into it. And I said I was going to check the mailbox, and so I would go in there before them and check the house. And the Lord spoke to me and he said to me, you left the house in my care. So what do you mean you're going to check the house? So I just said, well, just go to the mailbox and leave it alone. He left it to me. So once he left it to me, they don't need for checking on anything. You know, I got the message. So, but I tell you that I'm covered and the Lord is leading the way. Today, well, I remember those people who are in harm's way today. I didn't know that a subway was some place for people to go in and hide from bombs and all these things, but that's why I saw you now. And I don't know if that's why they made them or what, but truly it's a good thing they had the subway for these people to go in, and I saw little babies there in the stroller, little children playing, having fun. The man said, you have a guitar for his child, having food. They don't know what's going to happen. My God, you know, your life just turned over in a moment. It's about talking about war, right? I, feel good about these things, because when in the Gulf War, when the U.S. went down and invaded the country down there, there were children there, there were people there, old, young and old and whatever. And a lot of bombs were dropped down there and destroyed the whole place, you understand? The invasion there was even worse than this one that you see here going out of Europe. It was, you know, a whole lot of things would have happened already, you know. So, I don't apologize. I don't feel good about it, because I know that God has his people all over the world, and people deserve to be able to live, you know, and God put everybody on the earth, so. But this is the end time we're in. Bible talk about troublous times. And I'm gonna sing, I don't even know where to start. Last night, as I told you, when I wrote, I had tears in my eyes when I thought of the whole thing. Nobody who is any, if you're a child of God and really have a fear of God in you, you can't feel good about what's going on, and you cannot but feel a heart of sorrow. And the thing is that there's worse to come. Right, so we want to make sure that we are anchored.
Hey, birds.
anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll, fastened to the rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love. And I pray that today that is true, because there is a rock. There's a rock. And Jesus is that rock today. Now more than ever, we need to be anchored in that rock. Amen. You know, the ship goes out and it has an anchor. And the ship must have an anchor. The ships had anchors when they made them centuries ago. They still do, because they need to be able, when they get into shore, they can't just be sitting there in the water, because the water keeps moving back and forth and drifting back out to sea. So they need an anchor that will stick into the ground, right, to hold the ship right there, that it doesn't move, because the waves will cause it to drift away and go back into the sea, right, which they don't want to go back to sea. You want to stay in the port. You want to stay at the port where it is safe. You want to stay in the harbor. All right, so it was, so it will be. It's always been like that. The ship must have an anchor. Oh my God. If you are, it's not easy, I'm telling you. Last night I watched the news and I turned it off and the guy took it over to bed. And during the night as I'm sleeping, I wake up, I'm thinking about it. Like I said, I'm lying down here in my bed and I'm safe and I'm comfortable. And I'm thinking about those who are not safe. There are lots of things we take for granted, you know. But all of those things, you know, and some people still haven't learned, you know. All of what is happening in 2020, they just say, well, you know, things we just brush over and they don't understand when the end time, you know. You may never have lost somebody to the plague, or maybe you don't know anybody who died of the plague, but a lot of people were affected one way or another. Because when one person dies, it's like it affects the whole family, I mean, a lot of people, you know what I'm saying? And some people didn't even get to go to a funeral. They weren't allowed to even say their last words to these people, right? And these things mean a whole lot. This week I was at a Zoom thing for a funeral service, and believe me, I never done it before, and the first time I was doing it. And I said to myself, this thing is so impersonal. I mean, how could somebody think that this can replace a funeral service? I tell you that you must stare at a picture and you can't interact with people. I mean, at a time of grief and mourning, how can that replace reality? You know what I'm saying? I mean, who would be so stupid to think that, you know, this is what you must accept, you know, that's the way to go. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of people, this is the way they expect you're supposed to concept of worship, that you can't interact with person, you can't touch them, you can't reach out to them. You know what I'm saying? I mean, these things have their place. I'm saying, like, I'm on this program here, but when it comes to funeral, things like that, you want to interact with people, you want to touch people, you want to greet them, you want to grieve, you know, grieve and all that sort of thing. You know, it's something that's what this world has come to, I'm telling you. And people still don't realize it. Still holding on to this world, thinking that things will get better. Oh my God.
Lord, yes. Jesus, Lord above,
our strength,
love and today,
stand in a frame by the Lord, Jesus,
since we talk prayer, that we're going to pray. You know, in all of what I see what's going on, you know, as the world comes to this condition, I see how God is left out of the picture. I listened to the president of Ukraine. He was saying, I found out last night that he's of Jewish descent. His family was in the Holocaust, and he called for their solidarity. At one point he said they're not worrying about, basically nothing was going to happen. I didn't listen to what he was saying because I know what's in my spirit. I follow what God showed me. And he called for their solidarity, unity, but he didn't call for their prayer. And these things puzzle me, you know what I'm saying? They don't call for their prayer. They don't call for their prayer. But we who are children of God and disciples of Jesus, we know that God has his people there in Ukraine. He has his people in Russia. He has his people in every country. And we are not taking, when it comes to God's people, we know we're praying for God to protect them. And we're also praying for them too, the innocent people who get caught in this whole thing. And so we want to pray at this time, and we want to take this to the throne of grace. Last night, it seemed as if the whole place was going to tear down, but I understand from the news that they kind of halt everything, and we talked some more about it, but everything is set there anyway still, just to explode. So at least the people live through the night. When I look at the place where they're having these wars, I'm telling you, the places are covered with snow, and I see soldiers lying down in the snow. I don't even know. You know what I'm saying? It's brutal weather. Somebody was talking about how the man came to the border and he had to turn back, leave his wife and his children and let them cross over. And he has to go back because he has to go back to fight for his nation. And he said that they didn't even want gloves, you know what I'm saying? This is what happens. Maybe they had gloves, yes, but in the middle of the crisis, they just had to run. You know, run for your life. And it's just for survival, you know what I'm saying? And just to keep yourself alive, you know what I'm saying? So, it's brutal weather. I don't know, I'm telling you. It's brutal weather, as the man said, and I could see from the TV. It's brutal weather. And, you know, for those of us who know winter, that, you know, it has its own hardships going through it. You know, I'm saying it's not summer, and it's not even spring. You can tolerate certain amount of, you know, cold, whatever. You have to be prepared for these things. And for all that's going on, I'm telling you, very since you talked, well, we gotta pray. We gotta pray.